Hello everyone, welcome back. This is your friend SG and in this video we'll be seeing how we can create this memory game. All of us have played this game, so it's really simple, but we all love to play this game. Okay, so let's just create our own version of this game. For this, this is my JavaScript HTML file. We'll need Font Awesome for this. Okay, so you can just go to fontawesome.com and create your own account there, and then you will get the script tag. Okay, so we'll need just this script tag. And one more thing we'll be needing, that in the JavaScript I have these 50 different brands. Okay, these are all the things that we are going to use. Okay, so just a need one thing, that in Java, in Font Awesome, each and every image or let's say an icon that we get, it's of a form I and a class, and here comes the brand. Okay, after the hyphen, let's say we want WordPress, so we'll write WordPress. Okay, so this will give us the icon of WordPress. Okay, so this is the thing that we'll be using, and these are the different 50 brands that I have added here. You can add any of them. These are basically the images that we'll be using in the account, in the game. Okay, so let's just begin. So this is the version of our game, that this is the basic HTML code that we have written. Okay, from here we can select the different levels. Okay, so let's just give it a styling a little bit. This will give us the image in the background here, and the font family I have changed. Okay, so okay, let's just do one more thing. It's 100 viewport heights, and the image is in full. Okay, and one more thing to the h1 and the So this is the HTML. Now let's begin with the JavaScript. In the JavaScript, we'll be writing this start game function. Okay, so let's just initialize the function, and here we'll be getting 2-3 different things. The game container, then we'll be getting the score div, the where we'll be displaying the score. Okay, it can't be const because we'll be updating it in the future. So then we'll be having this level. Okay, we'll need the value of it. So then we are having the score, that is 0 initially, and the difficulty. So at the end we also need to return false. Okay, so what's difficulty? Difficulty is that here we are getting this, let's say this is a matrix of 4x4. Okay, so this is the level that we select from the drop down, and this 4x4 matrix that we are given, this 4, it's the difficulty of the game. Okay, so let's just initialize it, this difficulty. So if level is easy, then difficulty, it will be a 4x4 matrix. Okay, and in the same way we'll initialize it for all other difficulty levels. Keep in mind one thing, that these difficulty levels, they all need to be in even, they all need to be an even number, because if they become odd, then we'll be having one single box that is left, and that single box won't be having any pair. So this will be an exception case, or let's say a edge case in the game that we don't need. Okay, so for that we are keeping all the difficulty levels as even. In an even number you can go with anything up to 50, because here we have used 50 different images. Okay, so now what we do, we are creating a copy of this branch array. Okay, so let's give it a name, let's just give it a name of branch 2. Okay, so how we can create a copy of this, json.parse then json dot stringify, and then we'll pass the array. Okay, this will create a copy of this in the branch 2 variable, and we also need a variable for the to store all the selected values that, okay, that we are choosing. Each and every time we won't be using all the 50 images. Okay, so we need, we'll be storing the selected ones in this array. Now let's just run the loop. Here we'll be filling up this selected brand array. Okay, so let's just create a random variable, random brand. It will be storing a random element from this branch 2 array. How we'll get this, we'll splice this array. Okay, branch 2 dot splice. How splicing works, this will return us a single element because we have specified one. Okay, at the position that we are going to fill now. Okay, so for filling the position, we are going to get a random index from this. Okay, and the number that we are getting, its length will be branch 2 dot length. Okay, now this number could be a decimal, so for that we are going to use math dot floor. Okay, so this entire thing, this inner part, this will give us a random index. Okay, then math dot splice variable function, it will be picking out that particular element from the array and storing it in the random brand. Okay, now we need to push that element to the selected brand. Okay, so we'll push that element to the selected brand, but we'll be pushing it twice. Why? Because we need that each and every element needs to be twice present, twice, so that we can create a pair for that. Okay, now here we'll be creating the matrix that we were seeing. Okay, now we have filled this selected brand array, now we need to create the matrix. Create a row, it will be document.create element, and here we are going to create a div. Okay, now again we are going to use the run a loop from difficulty to j more than 0. Here again we are going to create a column this time. Okay, but it will be a document of type I, because here we are going to fill this. Okay, so now we need to add classes to it, so call.classlist.addClass. Which classes? First one is FAB, then again we need to add a class, but this time the class will be FA hyphen. Now we need to get the class. Okay, the main part comes here. Again we are going to use this same thing. Okay, we need to get a random element, and that element's class will be made, but this random element will be from the selected brand. Okay, so what it will do, it will get a random element from the selected brand and add it to this class. Okay, so the class will be FAB, and the second class will be FA hyphen, let's say something React, or it could be something like Cora, Python, anything, but only those variables which are stored in the selected brand class, the selected brand array. Okay, now we are going to add this to the row dot append this column. and then we are going to append this row to the game container. Game container dot append this row. Okay, so this is it. Let's just refresh it and see. Okay, so we got this. Now let's just change the array. You see what we are getting? We are not overriding that gamer container. Okay, we are adding new rows to it. We are appending it. Okay, so each time new row gets added to it. In order to override the previous ones, we need to do game container dot inner. We need to empty it each time we call this function. Okay, now it will work fine. Let's see. Okay, see, each and every time we add a new row, it gets override. Okay, see, so in the expert we'll be having a matrix of 10 cross 10. Okay, and each element will be present twice. So let's see, this JS, it's present twice, medium present twice, GitHub present twice, Dropbox, Gulp, everything, each and everything is present twice. Okay, so half the part is done. The next half, the main logic of the game, where we can get the score and we'll be seeing that whether the elements are a match or not and everything else, we'll be making it in a second part. This video is a bit longer, so second part will be coming soon where we'll be completing this game. Okay, so till then, stay tuned to the channel, share it with your friends, and for any help you can contact me on Instagram or Telegram. You can find the links in the description. Thank you. Tata, bye bye.